Look just how far we've come. Never minding that, of course, most of that distance was made by swimming through a sewer, let's just not think about it. Hey everybody, it's Chugga Conroy! Welcome back to more Splatoon! Last time, we made it to Area 5 in Octo Valley and took on one of the first challenges there with our sniper rifle, seeing what was better, me or the Octo Snipers. Too much surprise, it was actually me. This time, we find ourselves at yet another one of these kettles at Pinwheel Power Plant. Slip through defenses. I love it already. Let's get into it. You guessed it. It's Amiibo Challenge time yet again. Hey, yo, what's crackin', playa? We are gonna be not cracking it all over this stuff because you not a inkling squid Amiibo. Let's
go.
Yeah. So the roller challenge in this surprisingly bright and cheery looking area. I kind of thought it would look more bleak because, you know, we're in the final stage and they ain't messing around anymore. We got to not just ride ink rails to get to the stages. We got to do some actual platforming, get serious business. This stage, gonna be riding around in these moving platforms quite a lot. And I'm gonna say it right now, the challenge of this is going to come not as much from the roller, but more so the fact that I can't use burst bombs to quickly get things done when everything is moving. I thought this would be a fun challenge. We haven't really had a whole lot of actual challenge when it came to using the roller, so I thought it would be a good fit. Besides, I do want to give all the Amiibo challenges at least one more run in this final stretch. Go ahead and destroy these, and just when you think they're going to give you a branching path and you're going to find a secret island, nope, just takes you back to the standard pathway. Again, I do kind of wish these levels were a bit more open-ended. Perhaps in a sequel it could be. Gonna drop that right there. You're not gonna get away in time. You're not getting away that easy. We're gonna get some armor. Throw that down. What? Can I do that to this guy too? No, okay, that's not gonna make it work. Throw it there. No. Come on, I want to do that again. That was funny, come on. Man, apparently you didn't think so. I mean, I guess it did cause one of your relatives to die, so I could understand how you maybe might not find that so funny, though, but I found it funny. Come on. Join your... Okay, he's not gonna... It actually pushed him back a pretty respectable distance, even that far away. Okay, fine. I will get on your level and then throw the bomb. Of course, that doesn't work. All right, I'll use the friggin' Zuka. There are more in the stage, and this is a lot of fun. You can just plow right through their shields as if there's nothing there. Nope. Until the last second, I thought that was solid ground, and there wasn't a pathway there. Ouch, what a time to lose one of your three lives. Gimme. Now, it is the canon ending that you get killed in this humorous way, so he just walked off the cliff that time. He was running away from the bomb and just chose to walk off the cliff instead of taking it like a man. I think he was far enough away that it wouldn't have hurt him anyway as well, so that's... Okay, buddy. If you think that was really the lesser of two evils and the smart pathway to go, who am I to question your legacy? Legacy. Let's go onward. Got more of these moving platforms. We had a checkpoint and we're back up to three lives as well. I'm definitely enjoying that. Go up and be in the perfect timing to bop our head on that comedically. You can probably take one of those, I bet. No, wait, he's in the ink. Is he low enough now that the bomb can hurt him? I'm so amused by the fact that I can kill these guys with the bombs that I'm just wanting to do it every time now. No, I can't. Oh well. Enjoy having a goofy underside. There you go. And this crate right here that I almost missed. This crate that is in plain sight, not hidden from your line of sight whatsoever, one of the most obvious crates out there, has the sunken scroll in it if you were playing in Octo Valley. It is probably the lamest sunken scroll placement of them all, and I don't know why it's easy, because most of the sunken scrolls, even back in Area 1, were hard. That one in the first stage, I remember that I didn't get that my first time around. It took me a repeat play. We had another guy just run off the cliff. The bomb didn't even land on the platform. Wow. But yeah, usually the sunken scrolls, they're pretty tough. I missed some in Area 1, including the one in the first level. And hey, look, they drew a squid in the ink. That was cute. You just, like, showed me, like, what you were going to do with me after you killed me. And you might have actually... Oh, God. I am almost dead. I am without armor. There goes my egg bonus. I think the smart approach is going to be throwing bombs at you, getting you stuck in my ink so you're helpless, and then approaching. I already lost my egg bonus on my armor, so I don't want to lose my ink zooka as well. Throw that. Nope. You're pretty helpless. There you go. I think I can take one of you just fine. Got that. And hi, buddy! Got very up close and personal with you there. Roland? I think we're just about done here, actually. Right below us, there's a balloon, which I'm not going to miss. Yes, had the foresight to actually look ahead for once. And now that jump looks like nothing I want to actually chance. So let's just ride this and be on the safe side. Hey, I get currency in the form of babies for it. Come on, I don't want to use this. I don't want to use this. I don't want to use this. Yes, got it. Okay. Wasn't sure if I could. Now, we have sideways spinning platforms, and I can't use my dang burst bombs. This is what I was talking about when I said we might have some actual challenge this time around with the roller. You, let me go. Maybe this area will be the time we have actual challenge? I'm not really sure. I think I've come to realize that the roller challenges just aren't much of a challenge whatsoever, but they are kind of fun every once in a while. Still glad we're doing it. Onward, kill you. And I just realized we have more than enough eggs for our bonus, and I can't even use my gun in this challenge. Wonderful. Whoa, I didn't know that would push me. That doesn't make any sense. It's above me. Like, it's not cutting into the ground whatsoever. Sound like some kind of French opera singer or something like that. I'm so sorry to my people. Come on. Come on. Come on. Oh, gosh. Oh, gosh. You can die. There's nothing below us, surprisingly enough. That's where I'd hide eggs, you know? If I, you know, I'm not a level designer, but I feel like if I was, you know. Wow. Get you. And then I think from here, it's just going to be making this jump and then staying on the platform for it to make a full rotation. I guess I could be daring. Yes, I will. Oh, whoa, that almost cost me right there. Kind of. Or I can just make it take even longer for myself. Unless I get on top. Yeah, this was not challenging hardly at all. I did have a near-death experience right there, and I did die once because of my own stupidity, but we made it. As for the sunken scroll that long gets skipped over because we keep doing these amiibo challenges, why are we here? For what purpose do we exist? We must not dwell on these questions. We can merely trust in the will of the universe and spend our days and nights in harmony with the world, celebrating this festival called life. This refers to something that we have not touched on yet. I've gotten a lot of questions asking if I will be talking about what this is relevant to, as it's no longer something you can do in this game. But I will personally assure you that yes, at some point in the future, we will go over this. I have a plan. And no, this plan won't take 6 years to carry out like every other bonus video I promise I'll do. It really will happen. This time. Whew. You bet I'm good. Dodged a bullet. Which I had better be able to dodge bullets considering what exactly we are playing. And once again, we pass Amazing Miiverse Post after Amazing Miiverse Post on to our topic of today, which is once again the arcade machine. Since we, as you know, where's my other games? Where's my other... I'm signed into the wrong profile, aren't I? Meaning I restarted the game to sign into my main profile for nothing. If only my bullet dodging skills could have lasted until the actual games, but I guess maybe I can save a little bit of face in playing the game you unlock by beating the Area 4 boss, Ravenous Octoma, in the Inkling Boy Challenges. You see how I'm doing this. That game is... Go Squid Racer, go Squid Racer, go! There's a reason why I chose to sing a song that's only 4 seconds long and you heard what it was. This is surprisingly not just a typical racing game that doesn't have a whole lot of depth to it. You are able to jump similar to Squid Jump to jump ahead. You have several opponents. You do get more points based on how you place in the race. Getting first will get you some, second will get you others, third will get you others still. There is a time limit to the tracks, and there's several tracks to play on. I don't think I've seen the end of this one either, but out of all the games that you can play while trying to find a match online, this is probably my favorite of them, and this is one that I do play for fun every once in a while at the arcade cabinet. By holding down the 2 button at just the right time, I'm trying to get it right. I guess I'll save that for a minute because we have a power-up right here. This does make you move a little bit faster. As long as you're glistening, you do have it. Fortunately, I didn't get all the way to the end. Now, if you hold down... Can't do it right. Jeez. Another power-up to distract you from my bad ability, Zapfish. It allows you to violently consume these jellyfish. Fortunately, it's an 8-bit game, so you can't see the beak snapping and... shredding them to bits, which would definitely raise the age rating of this game if they did that. You know, it's not an M-rated game, so we're kind of making it so by describing the gruesome details of what is actually happening to these jellyfish. Gotta make it more mature, you know. You gotta make it so they got guns, they got cussing, not these squirt guns and cute little jellyfish. What are you talking about? I cannot do this timing to save my life. Okay. Even though I do it fine in Mario Kart, and it's the exact same timing, just know that you can do a boost at the very beginning of the race if you start holding down the button when the 2 is becoming a 1. Let's try it again. Nope, still can't do it. Trying to see just how long I can survive. There is a time limit to these races, as stated before, and if it were to run out, I would lose a life here. You do get 2 extra lives, so it is a bit more forgiving than Squidball, thankfully. I really think Squidball could have done with something like that. You're not gonna win! Or, well, I was right that he wasn't going to win. He didn't win either. Man, I can't get this. I was just doing this fine. I was playing this earlier today. How did I forget the timing in an afternoon? I don't know. I swear I play this game a lot, guys, and I play it for fun. All right. Let's consume you. That'll teach you to beat me in a race. I ate you after you got through the finish line, so you only get to know the days of victory for a few seconds. Yes, I did it right. And of course, they're keeping up with me very competently now that I've done it. You can allow me to consume these invertebrates and boil them in hot oil. I wonder if you can actually eat jellyfish. I don't know if they can. I guess maybe they can still sting you after they're dead? I don't know. I want to test that out. Jellyfish always look delicious, though, but I wouldn't dare try to stick one in my mouth. I'm sure some scientist out there did it to test how painful something was. I've heard about scientists doing that, making it their mission to get bitten by every animal to see how painful they are. Still hanging in there. I'm on, wow, stage 12. I don't always get this far. We have one final power-up, the sunfish. At least I hope it is one. Gives you very tight handling. Very important that you pick it up in hallways that are very windy like this. Because if you don't, you're probably going to fall behind and not be able to recover because you can't stop bumping into walls. Didn't get a rank bonus there, but I still did it. Wow, I see how narrow this is and how it's just going to force us into eating everyone. I kind of like this idea for a stage. Come on, give me that. Now if I can get you, if I can make myself bigger, I'm even more likely to eat these guys as I pass by them. As they're bouncing off the walls. You're the last one! Yes! I consume everything! Roar! Stage 14. I don't even think I've gotten this far before. I haven't even lost a life yet. I gained an extra life because I've been doing so well. See, come on. I guess just to restate this from when we went over Squid Jump, you do get to resume where you left off after a game, which is a very nice thing for them to do so that you can just kind of gradually play through this. Holy crap, I almost failed that, and I felt like I did well. Get another weirdly shaped stage. Got that again. Got the speed booster. I can still see the first place person on my screen. If you could run into me right now, that would be lovely. I'd very much appreciate that. Yes! Sniped! Devouring your competition is a great way to learn races. Learn by my example. Wow. Suddenly everyone just got the gas right there. I'm gonna fail this. I'm already gonna fail this. These later stages are unforgiving. Yeah, there's 2 seconds left. 1, 0. Look at that! Over already! Nope, I didn't get the boost out of the gate. I think I failed it again. I'm just gonna go until I get a game over, which probably will be pretty soon. So if you don't like this mode, then I'm not going to waste much more of your time with it. Oh, right, if you pick that up, you no longer have the Zapfish. No. Time up again. If I had the boost, I might have... Okay, maybe I can eat these guys and get it then. Nope, missed the speed booster. If I can eat one of you, maybe. Nah, it's going to wear off right before I get... Oh, no, I did. Is that going to be enough? Nope. Didn't even have it on screen that time. Come on. Nope. This is my last chance. I gotta do it. Missed. I think I'm dead. I'm dead. Come on. Nope. Missed that speed booster too. It didn't even get it on screen. Okay, well, that was a good run. I think that's further than I've ever made it. Stage 16, I believe that there's 20 stages in all. Gives you a lot of content, a lot of bang for your buck. If you're going to be gaming on Splatoon for an entire night with your friends, this will make sure that you're not bored while you're looking for spots to fill the rest of the room. It's great. Now with that done, on to the weapon of the day. Let's get right down to it. Rapid Blaster is next. Strangely, with higher range than a range blaster. I wonder if they got the names backwards. Anyway, true to its name, this fires exploding rounds very quickly, for blaster standards anyway. The drawback, as one would expect, is that it cannot kill in one hit no matter what. A direct hit is 80 damage, while an indirect hit bottoms out at 25. In most situations, this works out to a pretty certain two-hit kill as long as the shot is on mark at the first trigger pull. As per usual, wait until the right moment to pull the trigger, and don't telegraph with continuous fire because you'll be a sitting duck if you do. Rapid Blaster's game is about spacing that range and bullying weapons that have startup time. Special depletion is light. Its sub-weapon, Ink Mine. Don't see this terribly often. Great to place when you think you're about to die or when playing distraction when bullying. Of course, it's once again good in tower control because you can stick this on the tower, and that's probably the mode that it shines in the best. And its special is Bubbler. Actually one of the better specials this set could have had when it's very weak to being rushed at and can't continuous fire too well. This is not a very commonly played weapon and is actually kind of a joke in the community. I've met very few people who think the Rapid Blaster is anything good, but the few I have defend it up and down saying it's secretly a very good weapon, but no one gives it a chance because it doesn't one-hit kill, and any blaster main wouldn't give it a chance because that's exactly what people like about blasters. Treat this more as its own weapon class and not like other blasters at all. Usually, if you see it pop up, it's in tower control because movement is so predictable there, and it's very good at bullying whoever's on the tower very easily and has good range to back it up. Rapid Blaster Deco, on a brighter note, kind of. Same stats all around, but equipped with a suction bomb. As always, good for manipulation when blasters need to be at the proper space, and its special is Suction Bomb Rush, the rare special that is your reason for playing this kit all in and of itself, just like the only other two weapons in the game that have it. It's very powerful in Splat Zones and Rainmaker, enabling a team backed into a corner to just push everything back in an instant. Though it's not the fastest at building it up, as the few other lucky weapons to be blessed with this special have much better continuous fire and turf coverage. All in all, not an amazing weapon out there, but I do think it is secretly one of those pretty good weapons that nobody gives the time of day, and it does deserve a bit more attention. Here's your equipment, and I guess as a fun fact that I won't be able to talk about much of anywhere else, is that the Rapid Blaster was placed in the Coming Soon section of the Prima Guide for Splatoon, even though it was in the game at launch. This could mean it was originally intended to be DLC, or it could mean that Prima Guides are just as wrong about everything as they were when I was a child. Probably the latter. It's time to play luck-based maps that are never what you want. Let's see what we get stuck with playing this time. Mori Towers? No Camp Triggerfish. Well, almost as bad. Did you bring the marshmallows? No, but I brought hot dogs. We've seen this one already. I've already made jokes about a certain topic that is very relevant to something we saw earlier that I alluded to, not being subtle whatsoever, and I guess we can see it is maybe not nearly, not maybe not almost as bad, but better than I expected. Museum Dolphonsino. Had an art show for local Inkopolis artists here. We had to perform for, man, they are just piling on the references and making me not crafty whatsoever, oof. Now for the current ranked battle stages, Port Mackerel. I love the salty sea air wafts through here. It takes me back to our childhood in Calamari. Flounder Heights. I really like this part of town. I wish I could live here, but it's just so pricey. You know, those television news anchors, they don't make enough money to get by. They're totally known for doing that. I want to take a look at what the mode is, because if it's tower control, okay, now it's Rainmaker, that made up my mind for me. If it was tower control, maybe I would risk it by going into S rank, even though it's a weapon I'm not terribly good with. Otherwise, Turf Wars it is. I'm gonna be just as forward as the numbers that you see before you. I don't play Rapid Blaster hardly at all. It's not a weapon that I personally enjoy playing, but in messing around with it and getting a feel for it so that I could make the bio, I kinda enjoyed it more than I expected to. Decided to go with special charge up. This hat is not the best in the world. The special saver might be a little bit nice because of the light special depletion, especially because rapid blasters do tend to die quite a lot. They get kills, but they also die in the process. They play for traits quite a bit. Decided to go for Ninja Squid. Great for spacing myself apart from my enemies, going undetected, popping out when I need to, ducking back in, getting out, that kind of stuff. And this shirt is once again my pride and joy, and I know so many people are jealous of it, so it makes me so happy to show it off once again. And of course, gotta have my red sneakers. You know what these are. I've gone over their abilities multiple times. My look is... The bland beachgoer. I think this is seriously the most bland, uninspired look from a fashion perspective I have ever taken into battle. I would be ashamed of myself if I chose the contact lenses so it also looked like I had no headgear on. It's Cool Boy! Cool Boy! Museum d'Alfonsino, I'm not sure how I feel about this. I mean, I'm happy I get to say Alfonsino like I always do. It's just so funny. You know, about people getting mad about me mispronouncing d'Alfonsino the first time that we got this, that always seems to be the case. Whenever a name gets mispronounced in a video, it's always that one name that the commentator says like 8 times in the video. And the mispronunciation wouldn't hurt and make you wince nearly as much if they weren't always saying it. There goes my grandmaster plan of getting my bubbler built up so I don't have to fight fairly, because I would die instantly if I were to. I think I'm gonna have to lay down some ink mines on pathways that people are gonna go to. Luckily, it is pretty predictable where people are gonna end up. That is in a very good spot, whoever laid that. I'm guessing it was the NZAP because they were playing the orange one. I think that's the 89. You're still there. If I could just throw an ink mine, that would be wonderful. Never minding the fact that it would completely undermine what the weapon does, but hey, you! I always seem to say you whenever I'm gonna shoot somebody and I'm so sure I'm gonna hit, but then I don't. Come on. Gonna go up this way. Need to get up there. Lay down an ink mine. Nobody? Really? Where did they go is what I wanna know. Nothing? I thought this was area was gonna get a lot of traffic and that we'd see my ink mine actually come in handy, but nope. You're doing a suction bomb rush. I kinda wish I had that on my kid. Nope, you do not do that to me! Good sir! You treat me like the squiddling being that I am! And shoot me dead like the terrible rapid blaster user that I also am. At least you're fair and not discriminatory about respecting my negative aspects. Man, I am gonna suck so badly. Ooh, I killed Cool Boy. I should be happy. He is the coolest kid on the block after all, and I guess since I killed him, that makes me the public enemy number one, which is almost as good, right? I don't know. I just want to get my bubbler. I'm gonna need that if I'm gonna do much of any fighting. It is kind of fun splatting people from around corners with this, because like a regular blaster, it is no different in that one indirect hit followed up by another indirect hit is probably going to kill, so you can always check around corners reliably. Know that if the guy on the other side didn't bother to move in time, he is going to die. Otherwise, you have flushed him out regardless, and you can usually line up for another shot. Usually hitting around corners is very good. I wish there were actual corners for me to shoot around here that weren't always moving, but hey, can't win them all. Come on, 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 go, go. This is sad how many hits I have shot. My... Holy hell! I said I was having fun with this weapon earlier, but whatever skills I was having at that point certainly have left me by now. I swear I did all that footage for the bio myself, guys. Yeah. You! I brought you down with me and I just oh my gosh! Cool Boy is wearing the shades, the leather jacket, and the leather steel-toed boots. At least he's not just a cool boy in name only. He goes all in. I can't say he didn't try on his look. Ouch. I like how the guy's not just Chatamus. He's Chatamus X. Gotta be super extreme. We have lots of cool names in here. Unfortunately, though, I don't think I'm cool enough to play with the cool kids when I got this stupid thing in my hand. So let's switch. Very next game, I guess it wanted to have mercy and end my suffering early. We have double NZAPs yet again. Wow. So we have 2 Aerospray PGs and 3 NZAP 89s across the 2 teams. I never really thought of this map as a great NZAP thing, though, but I don't know, maybe there's something I'm not thinking of right away. There's not a lot of moving places you could, or any moving places, really, you can put the sprinkler. I guess Museum Dalfonsina might be the reason people are playing it. I'm not sure. Maybe I'm just getting lucky and there aren't really a lot of people playing it at all. Happens to the best of us when you get an enemy team of four ink brushes when it's Sniper City on Moray Towers, and quite frankly, I don't know how anybody makes that work, because even with long-range shooters, I seem to have trouble with snipers there.
Do this. Thinking. Got my bubbler. There are some corners I can play with here!
Oh boy.
I'm gonna super jump, maybe? I don't think there's anyone on the enemy team that can hit me from the other side!
You're just rubbing it in that you're playing one of the better weapons that has a suction bomb rush on it, aren't you? Yeah, yeah. You're being like, you should have gone with the Deco set because it's your favorite special, and I'm gonna kill you with it twice. If that guy didn't have a Japanese username, I would swear that he is somebody who knows about this being recorded and is just trying to mess with me because he knows what he's doing. Okay. Maybe this time
I can do a good job. Okay, that cloaked me pretty well. Corner doesn't. See you. I'm gonna drop this down. Really? They don't have two weapons that have suction bomb rush, do they? I think I only saw one Splash-O-Matic on there!
Yeah, well, I didn't need you to kill him. I had it covered. Thank you very much. Alright, I think at this point I am going to just play distraction. It's probably how I'm going to be best used to either team. I'm going to play risky, going to try to push the enemy back a bunch. Just kind of keep them pinned back to their base. I got a bubbler to do it with, almost. Crap, I am actually not that close to getting my bubbler. I outrange you, I outrange you. I do outrange you, don't I? Think.
Drop that. He's probably not going to run past that, let's be honest.
Not today! Finally got him. At least I killed him with the direct hit, too.
I think that was two direct hits, one after another. That wasn't so bad for just holding down the fire button. I think my ink mine just gave me a bit of special gauge. Gonna drop that right there. It's a pretty common place people run through, and I'll just kind of let that guard me a little bit while I cover the ground around these parts.
10 seconds remaining, and I think... Ooh, do we have this locked down or not? Okay, that ink strike going off at the very last second's good. It looks very 50-50 where we have about as much ink in their side as they do in ours. I think we're gonna come out ahead though, just barely. Yes, we do it! Are you proud of me for getting one kill? Cause it's better than I did in the first game. I'm improving. In all seriousness, I do still think this weapon is a bit overhated, and it doesn't deserve all the negative attention that it gets. I've seen so many jokes out there, like, I've seen many people say that they've never even seen the words splatted by Rapid Blaster appear on their screen, and I can kind of believe that maybe is a serious thing and not a joke, because it kind of doesn't happen that often if you don't play Tower Control, but, you know, I might not be good with it. Doesn't mean that I don't think it can be fun every once in a while, and that I don't think it at least has potential in Tower Control.
Now, Judd, how about you judge not only my games, but also my person?
Meow. Or excuse me, Mew, your vibe is toasty. Here's a little bonus of 100 coinage. Sorry, I was gonna say meow because I thought you were actually doing good today. You have been proving yourself out there on the battlefield, but today, you slipping, and it made me slip up. You see that you are inconveniencing others when you are doing a bad job in a team-based game, even to those not on your team, like me. How dare you, sir? Meow. If you see an arrow with an ally's name on your screen, that means they're about to super jump to your position. You should feel proud for finding a good location for them to jump to. By the way, if an ally's arrow keeps flashing repeatedly, they must be tapping your icon while still respawning, so hang in there.
I guess we're done here? That felt like it went pretty dang quick. Maybe I'm just used to how those rank battles go, but we're done. Next time on Splatoon, we're going to honor the memory of Cap'n Cuttlefish's voice by playing exactly the weapon he'd be proud to know we are playing. See you guys then.
Oh, and if you're worried about your favorite weapon being skipped over because the weapon order's been a little bit wonky lately, don't worry, we'll still get to every weapon eventually. If a weapon's being skipped over, it's because a guest is going to be joining us for it later. See you guys then.